Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and today it is my boyfriend again that came up with this idea. And I don't know why he came up with this idea, but I love it because if I don't have an idea, maybe he has one. So, I don't know if there is any... I don't know if this is a tag. I don't know what this is. He isn't that specific when he came up with the idea. It's just like a rough idea and I have to put it together myself. But the name of this video, and maybe this is a tag, if you want to do it, do it. So the name is The Price Isn't Right Makeup Edition. And I'm going to talk about 5 things that I would be okay to pay more for, and 5 things that I think are too expensive. And these are going to be products that I like, and not products that I hate. Products that I like, but I don't think they are worth the money, or I think I wouldn't have a problem to pay more for them. So I have making everything into dollars. Some of these are Swedish things, but I have... What is it even called? I've translated it. It's not called translating. But I'm going to say the price in dollars, but these are what the products cost in Sweden. Maybe things are cheaper where you live, but these are the prices in Sweden, and because I live in Sweden, I have to take the Swedish prices. So yeah, just a little disclaimer. So we're going to start with the 5 things I wouldn't mind to pay more for, because I think this isn't that interesting, because I think you know some of the things I really love. So yeah, I think we just get started. So we're going to start with 2 base products. We can start with my absolute favorite foundation. I hate to spend much money on foundation, but this foundation I would be okay to spend more on. This cost like $20. It isn't maybe the cheapest foundation, it's not that cheap, but I wouldn't mind to pay more for this because I really really like this, and I know a lot of people have this as their favorite foundation, and this is the Blur foundation from Lumene. I maybe should say what it is I'm talking about. I really like it, wouldn't mind to pay a little bit more for this because it's so good. The next thing is the best concealer I have ever tried. This is from Viva La Diva and it's their Argan Oil Concealer. This is not available in this color anymore, but I haven't found that color. But I love this concealer. This is the best concealer I've ever tried. This cost $10. It's like, how can it be this cheap and that good? I would, if my color come back, I would not mind to pay like $15 for this, because it's that good. I maybe don't even mind to pay like $20 for it, because it is that damn good. So if you want to make money off of me, Viva La Diva, take this back in my color and we have a deal. And the next one is my absolute favorite liquid lipstick, which is Nublas. These cost around $17. I know that is like a normal price for liquid lipstick, but I wouldn't mind to pay more for these because these are amazing. The formula is great, they are easy to apply, the little doofoot applicator is awesome, they stay on so good. I really love them and I wouldn't mind to pay more. Then the brush. I think you know which brush this is. That I can't believe how cheap this is. I know it was cheap in Swedish crowns, but then when I took it to dollars, I'm like, it's that cheap. It's $4 for a perfect blending brush. This is the V5 from BH Cosmetics. I've talked about this a lot, the latest, and my writing is almost gone on this. This is my absolute favorite blending brush of all times, and it's $4. I have 4 of these and I wash them pretty much, and I use them so much. They haven't lost any bristles at all. None. Not a single one of my 4 brushes has lost any bristles, and for $4 I'm like, how is this? It works with all shadows I have. This is amazing. I would not mind to pay more for this at all. And the last thing is ColourPops. palettes. Like almost all of ColourPop's palettes. These 9 pans cost $12 and I would be okay to pay more because these are so so good. I think that these are getting better and better. I have the Sol and the Mar. I'm not super impressed by those, but this Blue Moon, for example, these are so so good. And I don't know how ColourPop can keep the costs down, like with everything, but this $12 eyeshadow palette, this is so so good. Okay, and then we're into the things that I think is too expensive. I still love some of these, but I'm like, this is too expensive, you're not worth this, and it feels like you're paying for the brand. I guess you do, but it's like, ColourPop can have $12 palettes, and some of these things I'm going to show you, they should be able to be cheaper. So we can start with a primer, and it's the Smashbox Primer Water. And this costs $32. No primer is $32 good. No. It is a good primer, but I bought it half off, to my defense. I would not buy it for full price. Okay, so I don't know where it was, my father called. The Smashbox primer, this is $32. I think I came so far. I bought it half off. I wouldn't have bought it for full price because it's not that good. I have tried other primer sprays for like half of the price that I like more. So, not super excited about this. It's good if you have the money. Spend it, but I don't think it's worth the money. Another mist is, I only have a small size with this, and that is the Urban Decay All Nighter. I don't know if I have talked about this that much. I think this is a good setting spray. I have nothing to complain about it. Maybe that it smells pretty much, but like, it feels good, the makeup stays on, but it's not like mind-blowing. And the full size of this is $32. I think it's too much because there is really good setting sprays that does exactly the same for less money. Okay, I have two highlighters to talk about, and we can start with one of them, and it's the Ofra highlighters, and I have the old packaging, and this is Glazed Donut. It's the only thing I own from Ofra, and this cost $35. And I am like, it is good. It is really, really good. But $35 for this plastic packaging. First, I actually thought that Ofra was like a drugstore brand because the packaging was so ugly. They have changed it. I think this packaging was better than the new one. It is so plasticky. It's pretty heavy though, but it's really like, it's super plastic. And for $32, for $35, I think you could have done something more exciting with this packaging. The next highlighter is a glow kit from Anastasia. And not maybe this glow kit, because this I love, but their glow kits are expensive. They cost $62. And usually with Anastasia's glow kits, not all skin types can use all the shades. So it's like none of their glow kits suits everybody. I think that is a little bit strange. I think I could use all the colors, but I don't know if someone with a deep complexion can use like these two. And for me, this is a little bit strange. You should do like they do with their contour kits. Like a light contour kit, a medium contour kit, and a deep, dark, I think it's deep, contour kit. They should do different glow kits as well. Because they are expensive, and to buy like 6 or only 4, like some of them are, and you can only maybe use two of them. That is too expensive. I really love this Moonchild and I had nothing against it. Because I put it half off. Of course I did. But I would want to buy other glow kits from Anastasia, but they are too expensive for me for not being able to use all the colors. And the last thing that pains me a little bit to talk about is Melt, and it's the stack from Melt. I got two stacks. I have the Lovesick stack and Radioactive stack. The Radioactive stack is no longer available, I think, because they have made it into a palette. And this I found strange. One 4-pan stack cost $48, at least on Beauty Bay for me. And the palette with 8 colors, or the Smoke Session palette, cost the same. I know that these are bigger pans than the palette. These are bigger, but it's like, I find it a little bit strange to take the same amount of money for a palette, like a 4-pan stack. Maybe it's just me, but I think that is a little bit strange. These are really good. I really like them. I would have bought more stacks, I think, if it wasn't for the high price. Because I think the price is too high, because this is 4 single pans. So, that was my The Price Isn't Right makeup edition. I want to say makeup addiction. Makeup edition. Okay, we try again. So, that was my The Price Isn't Right makeup edition. I really hope you liked this video. I thought it was a fun idea that my boyfriend came up with. And I have seen that you like my talky videos where I talk about stuff. So I really hope you liked this video. And do you agree or do you disagree with me on some of these products? Do you think I mentioned products that are you think is worth the price? Maybe for example the glow kits. Do you think they're worth the money? Do you think the Melt sticks are worth the money? Or maybe do you think that ColourPop, the price is right on the palettes? Do you think they are not worth more than $12? Please let me know and we can share a little bit about that in the comments. And yeah, I really hope you liked this video. And if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos. And I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!